dhaoibh YouTube, comes to tattoo, beg me a rash. I still rarely get occasion to create a video, and I'm in an airport, in case you couldn't tell. And I'm trying to get to my connecting flight, which is, I don't know what gate I'm at now, but it's that way. So I'm going to go that way for a little while. That's kind of fun. Yeah. Needed to get an adapter. So I've had a couple of questions. So I'll catch you up. I'm in Helsinki at the moment, and my connecting flight is to Tallinn in Estonia. And yeah, there are lots of Moomin things around because, of course, Finland is the home of the Moomins and Lego, which is always nice. But I'm going to Tallinn to go to a conference slash workshop slash, yeah, with shout out, because we were invited, well, the director was invited to talk to them about launching an LGBT awareness program in schools, and she couldn't make it, unfortunately. So she asked, Stephen, you should go. You'd be very easy, very good at talking about these things. And I'm going, yeah, sure, why not? So look, I'm getting, it's a bit odd vlogging and walking at the same time again. I'm going to pause here and talk to you when I get to the gate. Well, thank God I stopped recording when I did, because I had to go through immigration to get to the other terminal and then find my gate this way. I'm now in a hotel, if you couldn't tell. Yeah, been pretty alright. The plane boarded like 20 minutes earlier, or they checked us in 20 minutes earlier, because we had to take a shuttle to the plane. Okay, so fairly standard room layout, although I thought I'd booked a queen and they gave me two singles. Could be worse. Taxi driver was nice, easy enough to talk to. Thank God I didn't try to book a car. They all drive on the other side. And the cars are on the other side as well, or the steering wheels. Yeah, that would have been fun on my learner's permit. Probably wouldn't have been able to book one anyway. Kinda hungry. Didn't eat in the airport, but kinda not hungry at the same time. It is now 10 to 1 local time. Yeah. So, I don't know whether to eat or not. I'm kinda not pushed. Might ring and ask if there's anywhere open. So, why am I in Estonia? So shout out, we're invited to come and do a workshop, conference, get together with people in Estonia who are planning on putting together their own programs to teach LGBT awareness in schools. So the director couldn't go, which, and then she decided to ask me to come instead. So I'm very thankful for that. Yeah, should be very interesting. Plan is to meet everyone at about 12 o'clock tomorrow, and then there's like a queer history walking tour of Tallinn, and then I think we're getting lunch and get-togethers and discussion groups, and then tomorrow evening we go to a reception in the Irish Embassy. So that's going to be fun. And then the day after, I can't honestly remember what the plan is. It's a little bit late in the night to be thinking that far ahead. But yeah. Also, I forgot my feckin' phone chargers, which again is just as well because they have different sockets. They have continental sockets. I had all these questions in my head, like, you know, how do you say hello, bits of the language, what's the weather going to be like so I know what to bring. And then I was in the airport going, what type of sockets do they have? You can tell I've done this before. Anyone who knows me will know that I'm an all right traveler. You know, if I know where I'm going and I'm on the right path, everything is fine. Even if I might run slightly late, which I was running late today, and then had to dash across the airport complex to the other terminal to get the connecting flight to here, which was all grand in the end. But yeah, I tend to leave things to the last minute, and when I rush, I forget little things like my phone charger. But, you know, this one has enough battery. There is a port. I have a power pack in my bag. I have a cable. I have my GoPros. Yeah, be grand. Yeah. If I do anything else tonight, I'll let you know. If not, I'll see you in the morning. Gurmila Malgut. Aita, I think it is in Estonian. And see you in the morning. Well, 3, 2, 1. Dhaoibh got dinner. I have to be very careful because the traffic kind of comes out of nowhere. But I'm currently going down what they call the long walk. There's a short walk as well, but apparently it's a lot of steps. So I'm kind of just retracing my steps from the tour that we got from Christina from the Estonian LGBT Association. And it's cool. The city is really, really pretty. It's really amazing. We went out down to, I think it was like the industrial district, and then there's like a fishing district beside it. We went for food and we went to a queer friendly bar yesterday as well, which was really good fun. The conference, so the basic premise of the conference was that the Estonian LGBT Association and GLSEN in America conducted a big school climate survey that GLSEN do a lot of around the world, but this is the first time that they've done it here. And I think they had something like 560 LGBTQIAP+ respondents who were all in school, who were all speaking about their experiences. And needless to say, whenever you read reports like this, there's never a whole lot of good stuff in it. There is some, but there's never a whole lot of it. So I look forward to kind of getting, hopefully, a copy of the full report in English, but certainly a summary of the report in English. But if you want to look at it and get an idea, go and look at the Belong To surveys or the national surveys for school climates in Ireland. And it'll give you a rough idea of how things are, because it's fairly translatable across countries, unfortunately. But yeah, so I checked out, all my gear is on my bag. I'm gonna go do a little bit of a wander, get a few souvenirs, and if I have time, I'll go back that way, which is, and it's gonna take me about 40 minutes maybe or so, to get to the rock climbing gym that was close by my hotel. Honestly, don't know if I actually will. It seemed like a good idea, and I brought my gear. But at the same point, I'm kind of going, and then I have to have time to get across to the airport as well, which is okay, about maybe 15 minutes from my hotel. But all the same, I don't want to be pushing it like I was coming through from Dublin. So we'll see how we go. I'd like to, just in case I forget, put out a massive thank you to Bella and shout out for asking me to come here, and then also to the Ambassador, the Irish Ambassador Francis I'm sorry I can't remember your surname, for throwing such a nice event the night before last. It was really, really good fun. You always make people feel very friendly by all accounts, and you certainly did for us. And I promise next time I'll actually wear a shirt. But it was okay. It worked out all right. So yeah, I'm going to have a wander. And yeah, let's see how we go. So I'll get better footage, but this is like the main square of the very old city. And I'm told there's a very good chocolate place. The oldest pharmacy in Tallinn, I think, is over that way. And there's a very good place to get beer and pies and things like that. Apparently there was a guy kept up there because he was the best archer in Estonia at an event, and they thought he will protect the city. And I can't remember his name, but he stayed up there until he was very, very old and couldn't see. So they kind of thought, we'll bring him down because it's not very good to have a blind archer. But that's him on the very top of the spire as a memoriam for it. But St. Nicholas is also the patron saint of Tallinn, I believe, as well. So that's kind of cool. He likes to get around. So, yeah. I'm kind of just trying to soak it all in as much as I can and trying to weigh up how much time I need to leave to get to the airport. But I found one nice souvenir shop, and I think I'm going to wander into another one. And then, yeah. Probably try and hail a taxi somewhere and vamoose back. But we'll see how we go. Now that's a facade. That's amazing. It's all these winding little side streets, and it's really pretty. But the architecture in Estonia still has a lot of Soviet themes, certainly in the lower parts of the city. You have all of this kind of traditional Estonian kind of wooden framed houses and architecture, and then the big blocks of apartments that would have been just for people to sleep in, go to work, come back, go to sleep, go to work, come back, go to sleep. So I like the kind of juxtaposition of it. It seems to sit in the city anyway. So, yeah, more touring. Falter Rash. I've forgotten how to say goodbye now. Naga something. Anyway. I feel like I've got everyone shopped for now, and I feel like it's now 10:30, 10:25 to 11. I'd like to be in the airport early this time as opposed to rushing through again. So I'm going to find a taxi, I'm going to get to the airport and just relax, chill out. No climbing, but another time. I might be back in June for Baltic Pride. Apparently they're trying to invite Rory O'Neill over, so if he's going, I'm going. So, anywho, slánga fóill, agus neamhastach, agus aitha for watching.
Yeah.
Welcome back, Falter Rash. Hüvasti is goodbye in Estonian. I asked one of the cabin crew for it, so. I'm now in Helsinki. It's 1:45 or 1:45, I think. No, yeah, 1:50. So my watch is actually right. Anywho, which means I'm still an hour ahead of Dublin,
but that's okay. So I have, I think, an hour at least this time. Definitely have an hour at least until my next flight. So I'm going to have some reindeer pasta in the Nordic kitchen, which should be interesting. It's like, it said cold smoked reindeer meat, portobello mushrooms, and pasta, obviously. So that should be nice. And have a pint of local Finnish IPA, which should be nice as well. Had some lovely beers. Thank you very much, Maith, for steering me in the right direction when we were out the last couple of nights. Definitely good IPAs. I'm kind of feeling tired now. I think maybe because the last time I was on the flight from Helsinki to Tallinn, it's only a 20-minute flight, but the last time I was doing it, it was midnight. So now maybe I think I'm feeling the reverse effect of it. I'm expecting to be traveling late and being tired. So, yeah, maybe that's what it is. Could be the 2 days catching up on me as well. I think the flight, then, all that remains now is to fly back to Dublin and go home, chill, edit, which I have to figure out how to do again because it has been a little while. I have to start making videos for work as well to promote the various things that we're doing on the wall. It's another thing to do, which is kind of good. I haven't had to think a whole lot up until about today about work. I know what's going on. But it's not massively important that I know any of it or do anything about it, so that's nice. Yeah. Dicky dip tomorrow. That's going to be fun. Won't video that for the sake of everybody's eyesight. It's not something you need to see. I just put up a new video on my Facebook page and on my fundraising page. Basically to explain my reasoning for doing the Dicky Dip in the first place. Aside from it being a very good cause, I thought I had testicular cancer about 15 years ago.
And well, I haven't done that for a while. Ran out of storage space on my phone. It had been warning me about that, in fairness. So, if I did talk to you about why I'm doing the Dicky Dip, it'll be on that clip. If I didn't, I'll link my Facebook post and fundraising page to my YouTube Facebook page, and then you can all see exactly what I'm doing and why I'm doing it. So yeah, I'm gonna cut short here. I'm gonna save you the whole kind of traveling through an airport montage or up through the clouds and all that jazz, because you see it a lot in other transport videos or flying videos. So yeah, we'll speak either before I get on the plane or after I get off the plane, one or the other. Hüvasti, Germagut, agus slánga fóla rís. Just in case you were wondering how they served it. Reindeer mince.
This is pretty cool.
I don't know.